Good morning, everyone. Welcome to your fluid mechanics experiment number 3, measuring the drag force of a golf ball and a smooth ball. In order to do this experiment, you need the wind tunnel. You also need two balls. One, the smooth ball. And two, the real golf ball with a lot of dimples. And also, in order to measure the force, you need the balance. The balance will give you the direction reading of the force. I want to stress a very important thing for this like balance. That is, you need to lock the balance all the time when you handle it. This is how you lock and unlock the balance. We have a screw over here. If you turn in this counterclockwise, this is release the balance. The balance will be able to measure the force. Now, if you're turning clockwise all the way to the end, this will lock the balance. Now, remember, the balance is a very sensitive device. It will be able to measure the force to accurate to 0.01 Newton. So it is very sensitive, and also in the meantime, it's very easy to be damaged. That's why you need to lock this device all the time when you handle it. So right now, it is locked. So in order to measure the drag force of a golf ball or a smooth ball, we need to mount the ball to the balance. Now it's going to be your decision, either you're going to do the measurement for the smooth ball first, then golf ball second, or you want to do this golf ball first, then you do the measurement for smooth ball. It's going to be your decision. I'm trying to measure the drag force of a real golf ball first. So carefully slide this golf ball. You need to unlock this a little bit. And also I want you to notice there's a little pin over here. When you slide this one in, you probably need to slide in with a different angle, like this way. Then turning around, you will be able to slide all the way down to the slot over here. Now you need to lock the golf ball, and also the balance is also locked. Next step, we need to insert the golf ball and the balance into the wind tunnel. Carefully insert the golf ball into the wind tunnel, and also remember you need to align those two markers to make sure that the golf ball facing the direction of the airflow. Tighten the hatch. Then we need to also connect the balance to the computer. The connection is here. There's only one way you can connect this to the computer. Lock the device. Now the golf ball and also the balance are ready to use. We can now power on the wind tunnel and come over here to the computer, click on the software icon and pick up exercise E, that is the drag force on bluff and streamlined bodies. Click on load. You will see a pop-up window like this. Remember to change the temperature from 18 degrees to 25 degrees, which is the room temperature here. And also, as you can see, the watchdog enabled is illuminated, which means the communication between the software and the computer and the wind tunnel are good. So everything is ready to use. So before we start the measurement of the drag force, we need to zero the software and also zero the physical balance quite a few times. How to zero the software? You just click on there's a zero button over here. Click on this multiple times. That's it. So now the software has been zeroed. You also need to zero the balance. How do we zero the balance? You just need to release the screw over here gradually, slowly, and then tighten. Do this multiple times. I usually do this 2 to 3 times. Tighten, then gradually, slowly releases. So the physical balance now is zeroed, and also the software is also zeroed. Now we can start to measure the drag force. And as we can see that the software, as we said, is everything is already ready to use. So we can give a fan potential equal to 20%. And you see the wind tunnel right now starting running. And we also see that the software gives us a reading about the drag force equal to 0.04 Newton, which is good. And also the velocity equal to 7.6 meters per second. Those are the two data points you need to record, the drag force and the velocity. So this is a 20%. Remember, you have to wait for 60 seconds to let the airflow become stable. Then collect your data. This is 20%. Now, when this step is finished, you can increase to 30% potential. Remember, wait for 60 seconds, airflow becomes stable, and you need to record the drag force and also the air velocity from the software. This is a 30%. Then increase this to 40%. Record the drag force and also the velocity. In this case, the drag force is about 0.11 Newton and the velocity is about 13.5 meters per second. So this is 40%. Now you repeat the whole process for 50%, 60%, 70%, all the way to 100%. This is 100%. Remember, for 100%, you also have to wait for 60 seconds to let the airflow become stable. Then you start record your data of drag force and the velocity measurement from the software. Okay. Now, the second step you're going to do is trying to repeat the measurement for the golf ball drag force one more time. So later, we're going to take the average of those two sets of data for data analysis. Okay. So now we have to wait the fan, right now I can see the fan still running, to wait the fan to be completely stopped. When the fan is completely stopped, we need to zero the software, zero the balance, as we said, multiple times, then start the measurement again. Just repeat the procedure we just did. The fan is stopped. So now we can start in zeroing one more time. We zero the software, click on this zero button quite a few times, and just as before, you need to tighten and release. Do this 2 to 3 times. Remember to do this gradually and slowly. So I'm tightening, lock the device, now release gradually. So now the balance and the golf ball and also the software are ready for, now as you can see, you have to zero this one more time. I say the number are not zero. So every time if you notice it is not zero, you have to click on the button quite a few times. So now the software and the balance, everything is ready to for the second measurement one more time. So we just repeat the procedure as we did before. So this is for the golf ball drag force measurement. Then you need to change the golf ball to the smooth ball to be able to compare the drag force between those two different balls, smooth ball and the golf ball. Now we need to change the ball. Remember, now you are handling with the balance. You need to lock the balance first. So let me lock the balance. This is a very important step. If you do not lock the balance could be easily damaged. So now the balance is locked. Carefully remove the ball and the balance from the wind tunnel. Release. Turn around the golf ball. Replace it with the smooth ball. Slide in like this way. Turn around. Then you will be able to slide this one all the way to the slot. This is tight and this is also locked. Carefully insert the smooth ball and the balance into the wind tunnel. Then repeat the whole procedure as we just did for the golf ball. Remember to zero the balance, zero the software, try different wind speed from 20%, 30%, 40% with an increment of 10% all the way to 100%. Then repeat the whole process for a second set of data. Okay? So that's going to be your experiment for fluid mechanics number 3.